And of course, Japan has also voiced concerns over Iran's nuclear move. A Japanese government spokesperson has called on Iran to return immediately to its commitments to the nuclear deal that Tehran signed with world powers in 2015. Iran earlier said that it had increased its uranium enrichment above the limits set by the agreement.
イランによる今時発表も含めですね、現在の核合意を取り巻く情勢や中東地域における緊張の高まりを深刻に懸念をしております。注視をしているところでございます。イランに対して、核合意を遵守し、核合意上のコミットメントに即座に戻るとともに、核合意を損なう、さらなる措置を控えるよう改めて強く求めていく考えであります。
And in other news now, the U.S. President Donald Trump has hit back at the U.K. ambassador to the U.S. following a leak of a confidential memo. Trump also told journalists that the ambassador, Sir Kim Darroch, had not served the U.K. well and that he is not a big fan of the diplomat.
We've had our little ins and outs with a couple of countries, and I would say that the U.K. And the ambassador has not served the U.K. well.
The UK Foreign Office has ordered an inquiry into the leak. The US Trade Minister Liam Fox, who is visiting Washington, has said he would apologize to Trump's daughter Ivanka, who is due to meet him during this trip. In a series of explosive memos to 10 Downing Street, the British ambassador Sir Kim Darroch had described Trump as incompetent, inept and insecure. Sir Kim Darroch, one of UK's top diplomats, used secret cables and briefing notes to question the US president and his government. In the diplomatic memos obtained by the Mail on Sunday, the UK ambassador hit out at the Trump administration and the bitter scandals plaguing the White House. The memos touched upon the upon America's ties with Russia and the ongoing tensions with Iran. The ambassador lashed out at Trump's economic policies. The memo attacked Trump personally as well, warning that the 73-year-old's career could, quote-unquote, end in disgrace. Now, Sir Kim also gave a scathing assessment of the White House, saying, and I quote here, "We don't really believe this administration is going to become substantially more normal, less dysfunctional, less unpredictable, less faction-ridden, less diplomatically clumsy and inept," end of quote. He also questioned whether this White House will ever look competent to the rest of the world. Referring to allegations of collusion between the Trump camp and Russia, the memo says that the worst cannot be ruled out. In one of his most recent documents, Sir Kim refers to the incoherent U.S. policy on Iran. He also questions Trump publicly stating reasons for calling off the retaliatory airstrike against Iran following the downing of an American drone. He says that it is unlikely that the U.S. policy on Iran is going to become more coherent anytime soon. This is a divided administration. And the ambassador claimed that Trump's economic policies could wreck the world trade system altogether. The memo says that this America First administration could do some profoundly damaging things to the world trade system. The memo also said that the differences between the U.S. and the U.K. on climate change, media freedoms and the death penalty might come to the fore as the countries seek to improve trading relations after Brexit. The top diplomat also suggested a mantra in order to communicate with the U.S. president. He said, well, that's his mantra. "You need to take your point simple, even blunt, to Donald Trump." The documents detail Sir Kim Darroch's judgment on the Trump administration from 2017 up until now and could prove highly embarrassing for the UK Foreign Ministry. But the UK Embassy in Washington has said that they have strong relations with the White House and that these would continue despite the mischievous leak.